Hello friends, I am Sanjay Gupta. I welcome you on Sanjay Gupta Tech School. In this video, I am going to demonstrate you about record types to control pick list values and record types displaying different page layouts in Salesforce Classic. So in this video, we will cover these two different points. Before starting, let me share you how you can search me on YouTube. You can type my name. My channel will be available there and you can watch Salesforce related video series there. So now coming on to the topic, first of all, I am searching for the custom objects. So right now I'm picking student object, and in student object, I have a pick list that is course. And in this pick list, I have four different values, BTech, BBA, MTech and MBA. So if I move to student tab and if I try to create new record, so you will see while creating records, all these values are available. So now my requirement is I have two types of students. One is engineering student and one is management student. So while creating record of engineering student, I only want to have these values, BTech and MTech. And while creating record for management student, I want BBA and MBA as the pick list value. So this we can do with the help of record types. So we need to create two separate record types, and through those record types, we will control pick list values. So let's do that. So if you open any custom object and you scroll down, you will see an option of record type. So here it is in Salesforce Classic. So right now we don't have any record type. We need to create new record type by clicking on this button. So for custom object, record type will be available here. If you are working for standard objects, so you can directly search for the standard object like account. And if you scroll down, you will see all the options. Like if you want to create validation rule, lookup filters, triggers, page layouts, record types. So all these options are available here. So for standard object, you can directly search it in the setup. And for custom object, you need to scroll it down for the related list. So now we are going to create two record types. So first record type name will be engineering student. It is active. Here it is asking to enable for profile. So you can choose for which profile you want this record type to be enabled. So I'm choosing all, clicking on next. Then it is asking for the layout. So we have two options, apply one layout to all profile or apply a different layout for each profile. So you can apply same profile, same layout for all profiles, or you can select different also. So right now we are choosing first option, apply one layout to all profiles. And clicking on save. So this way you can see your first record type engineering student is created and it is automatically showing the pick list values. Sorry, pick list available for editing. So on student object, we have three pick lists and we want to manage course pick list. So I'm clicking on edit. So right now I want only BTech and MTech. So I selected those only for course. Now we are going to create another record type. So here you can see one record type is created. Now we are going to create another one. So management student, it should be active also. We want to enable it for all the profiles. If you want to make it default, you can choose this one. And if you don't want, you can unselect. And right now you can see engineering student is the default record type for all the profiles. Then again page layout, so apply one layout to all or different. So we are choosing first option. Further in this video, you will also learn how we can attach separate layouts for separate record types. So here we have only one layout. So for both the record types, we are choosing student layout. But further, we will create separate layouts also. So two record types will be having two separate page layouts. So again, you can see pick lists are available here. So we want to modify course pick list. This time I am removing BTech MTech and selected values are BBA MBA and clicking on save. Right. So now I am making new student record. So here you can see this way record types will be available. So you can see two record types are available here. If you have entered any description, so that will be also displayed here. So while working for your projects or assignments, you should enter proper description so that user can distinguish which record type is for what. So if I choose engineering student and click on continue, so on course you will see only BTech MTech because these two values are related to engineering students. Now, if I again click on new and click on management student, so you can see BBA MBA are available here. So this way, our first point is covered, record types to control pick list values. So this way, all record type will be having available pick list values for the particular object. So you can choose either one or you can edit all the pick list values as per the requirement. So if you have more than one record types, then there may be a different pick list for different pick list values for different record types in Salesforce. But here you will see that page layout is same, like this management student page layout is same as compared to engineering student record type page layout. So now if you want to have two different page layouts for two different record types, like you want some fields to be available for one record type and those fields should not be available for another record type. So we can also do that. So for that purpose, again, I'm moving to the custom object student. And this time we need to create page layouts. So you can see we have one page layout, so we can use this and we can create one more. So we will do that. So existing student. So I'm creating one more page layout for management student. And the student layout will be used for engineering student. So now from this layout, I'm going to modify this these things. And from here, I'm removing these things. For management student, I don't want high school related information. And I'm clicking on save. So this time you will see I have two page layouts, management student and second one is student layout that will be used for engineering student. If you want, you can change its name also or you can clone it to make new one. And we have two record types, engineering student and management student. Now after creating both of these, either you can click on this page layout assignment or you can click on this page layout assignment. Both are same. So now you need to map page layouts with proper record type. So you can see we have three record types, master, engineering student, and management student. So right, if we have more than one record types, then master will not work. So engineering and management student, these two record types are working. And here you can see both record types are having same layouts. So now I'm going to update this one. So click on edit. I'm selecting management student, and from a page layout to use, I selected management student. So now you will see engineering student is having student layout as page layout, and management student record type is having management student as page layout. And I'm clicking on save. So these are record types, master, engineering student, and management student. Here you have profiles, and inside them you have layouts. So right now all the profiles are having same layouts for both the record types. But if you want different layouts for different profiles for different record types, then you can do that also, right? So here we can manage three things: record types, layouts, and profiles. So right now we have two record types that we are going to use, engineering student and management student. We have two layouts, student layout for engineering student and management layout for management student record type. And we have various profiles, but right now we are using same layouts for all the profiles. If you want a separate layouts, then you need to create more layouts as per the requirement. Right? So now I'm doing a refresh for student, clicking on new. So right now I'm clicking on engineering student and clicking on continue. So you are seeing this. Now I am making duplicate of this tab, clicking on cancel, clicking on new, and selecting management student and continue. So you can see for student, we have all the fields in single column. For management record type, we have fields in two columns. For engineering record type, you can see high school marks, percentage, and phone fields are available. But for management record type, these fields are not available because we have different page layout, right? So this way you can control page layouts with the help of record types. Right now we have same page layouts for all the profiles. If you want to change that, you can do that also by clicking on this edit assignment and choosing different page layouts for different profiles. So I hope you understood both the things, how we can control record types, how we can control pick list values through record types, and how we can display different page layouts using record types in Salesforce Classic. So I hope you understood whatever I demonstrated. Same thing you can do for standard objects by searching them here. So you will see both the things, page layouts and record types, right? So I hope you have understood all whatever I demonstrated in this video. If you want to follow Salesforce related videos, you can search my name on YouTube. Thank you for watching this video.